Hello everyone, this video is going to be a demonstration of how you can hide your API keys, which is ever more important, especially if you're using OpenAI now. I'm going to show you how to hide your key, how to access it from Python code, and also how to make sure that it never gets put onto GitHub. Okay, so before we do that, the first thing I'm going to do is actually just show you, you can revoke your keys, which is basically delete them. So this API key will immediately be disabled, request will be rejected, so let's go for that. And if you think your key may have been compromised, this is what you need to do. You will always need one key, so it won't let you delete the last one. But you can't see what that is, so I don't care that you've seen the start of it. Okay, just before we go into the details, I just want to show you this. So you may see some people use os.environ with the square brackets. That's fine, but you get the rather ugly error message if there is no key found. Now, instead of that, what you can do is you can use .get with the curly parentheses. And instead, you will see something a bit more user-friendly, which will be API key not found. So os.environ.get is the slightly more user-friendly version. Okay, so once you've got your key, what you want to do is go into your /.zshrc file, which is basically in your home directory, and it's got a dot because it'll be hidden. But if you notice there, or if you want to create one, go to the bottom and you can add it using export space OpenAI underscore API underscore key equals, which is the same, you see that here, that's in the zshrc file, that will match that, which is what you'll be using throughout your project. And that's your key, which you will get from OpenAI. Now, once you've put that in there, save it. And if you haven't logged out and logged back in, you'll just need to use source. So source space tilde /.zshrc. Now, if we run our Python code, and it's called lc.py, my particular Python file, and it prints the key. So it's found it. It's found it because it is finding it in the zshrc file. Now, the other thing I just wanted to cover, as it is, this won't get put onto GitHub, which is good, because it won't get committed because you won't add it because it's not in your working directory. The other thing to remember when you're using GitHub, rather than having a git ignore file in each project, which can be, you might forget to make it, you might just get bored of making it each time, you can actually do a global git ignore. And if you'd actually used a .env file instead of saving your API key in your zshrc file, you could actually tell Git to ignore a .env file. So basically it's saying don't transfer a .env file up to GitHub because you don't want to, because you don't want people seeing your key. So this is a very quick demo of how to hide your API key, make sure it doesn't get onto GitHub, and also once it's in your zshrc file, you don't have to worry about whether it gets onto GitHub or not, because it's never going to end up being transferred, because it's never going to be in your working directory. So yeah, thanks for watching. That's a really quick whistle stop tour of how to hide your API key, how to delete your API key from OpenAI if you think it's been compromised. And I'm sure you know how to create a new one, because you wouldn't be watching this if you hadn't. So thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon.